I'm going to present his work entitled Compression Fatigue Behavior of Extrusion-Based 3D Printing PLA Material. My name is Ricardo Claudio, I'm from Polytechnic of Setúbal, and this work was made with collaboration of my colleagues, Ricardo Batista, also from Polytechnic of Setúbal, João Dupont, Mark Leighton, Luís Reis from Technical University of Lisbon. So, as outline of this presentation, I'm going to present the motivation and objectives, the design of the experiments from compression tests, compression fatigue tests, and perform some conclusion. So, this work is related with an industrial application, where we want to stamp parts like this one that are called clippers from fuselage and typical components of aircraft. These are made typical of aluminium sheet metal with thickness less than 1.2 millimeters, 2024 aluminium alloy without heat treatment or with heat treatment. So the idea behind this project is to produce dies to stamp these parts. This is normally a rubber pad stamping where we only have one part of the die. And the pressure is made over the die with a stiff rubber to inform the part. So we want to produce dies with polymetric materials by 3D printing. This is because metallic is not yet completed. So by polymeric materials we could prove that this is at least five times faster, much less expensive, obviously depends on the. So the idea is to use polyatic acid to produce these parts. This is the most popular material in fuse deposition modeling process. And we proved that this support is demanding pressures for at least 20 cycles without any measurable deformation. So this is the parts that could be printed by 3D printing. And these are the results of the 20 cycles that. So, as objectives, we want to select the best 3D printing parameters for compression loads, understanding the fatigue limits of 3D printing polymers under compression and the failure mechanism, and define limits for an industrial application, in this case, stamping. So, we are using a PLA filament with 1.55 millimeters wide. The printer is like an open source Blox 1 and Kuiper 2, simplified 3D slicer. These are the fixed parameters that are used typically for applications with, for higher mechanical properties. So we design of experiments considering three parameters we believe that have higher influence on the mechanical properties, the layer 8, the number of contours, and the extrusion width. So we did a full factual design with 5 central points. So we tested a total of 29 specimens, and we found that responsive surface metallurgy is not needed because all presented a linear behavior. All these parameters represent a linear behavior. So, as compression results, we could find that profile number 5, that has the lower thickness, the lower number of contours, and the higher width, has the better mechanical properties. So, this is a printing sample. So, we have only one layer. The infill is like this one, and with minus 45 and plus 45 directions. The worst case was for the layer height with 0.2 millimeters and with several contours, 9 contours in this case, and with also 0.45 millimeters. So we also performed another analysis to the results. We found that layer thickness and the number of contours are the ones that have more influence on the mechanical properties, as you can see here. Extrusion width, in some cases, has no significance, but in some other cases, like this one we are present here, has some influence. The cross factors, we couldn't find any obvious relation with the mechanical properties. We found also a good correlation between the density of and the mechanical properties. This is also pointed by other workers like Tanikela and others. Better mechanical, the specimen that provide better mechanical properties have higher density, and the horse mechanical properties profile 8, the lower density. We also extrapolate the value of the mechanical properties to the filament density. You could find, for example, that maximum stress is 72 MPa. That is close to the one we got with profile number 5, that is 70 MPa. About the tensile tests, we obtain for the same properties we test the compression specimens. We found average maximum stress of about 45 MPa, which is quite below compared with the compression. For the fatigue tests, we did the fatigue tests according to ISDMD 7791 for polymers. We test in compression specimens like this one, according to ISDMD 695. Frequency 1 Hz, maximum temperature increase was less than 2 Celsius degrees. We test in stress control, world ratio 0.1 in compression with a servo hydraulic test machine. So, as fatigue data, we have here basking glow. We could find a good relation between the tests and the basking glow. We are performing much more tests. This is an ongoing work. We could also notice that the elastic part dominates even for tests with low number of cycles. So we can see that the part of the plastic part is much lower compared with elastic. So elastic dominates, and why basking glow fits so well the data we have. We also have some data about the accumulated strain. We can find here a relation between the accumulated strain and the number of cycles in the log-log coordinates. So we found we can see that we have a constant creep rate for the first cycles, represent about 30% of the total fatigue life. And this relates quite well, according to a power law, with the maximum stress, as we can see here in this figure. Doing some analysis to the materials printed, this is an example of the sample. We cut a piece of in the middle of the sample and observe this in the microscope. So this is the microstructure, the structure we are expecting. We have here the layers, it's only one layer. We have here minus 35 and 35 infill directions. So we are expecting something like this as the printing structure adapted to this size. So what we got was some voids here. That was expected. We couldn't find here the this structure as we would expect, more only the voids. We have here a quite rough polishing, but even if polishing was better, we think we could see this structure. If anyone in the audience could give us some help, how can we access this structure, it was quite grateful. So this is the specimens testing under compression loads up to 25% deformation. So we found no voids and some slip angles of 35 degrees. And at the surface, we also noted some cracks, as you can see here, that initiated, but then they stopped, we couldn't look. This is the expected printed structure, and this doesn't seem to follow this structure here. So, for the SEM fatigue, with fatigue tests, with the specimen test and under fatigue, for the specimen with a higher number of cycles, we found some voids close the surface with associated cracks that started at 45 degrees but then changed to 0 degrees, as you can see here. In the interior, you have several cracks normal to the loading direction. These cracks are a distance of the layer thickness, which seems to be between the layers, but as we couldn't see here the printed structure, we are not sure about that, but we believe on that. So, as conclusions, best printing parameters in compression are for the lower layer thickness and the lower number of contours, which has the higher influence in the mechanical properties, and for the higher contour width, but this doesn't have quite influence on the properties. So, compression results, we found 2.23 gigapascal of Young modulus and maximum stress of 70 MPa. In tension, we have lower properties, in part because the printing properties in compression are not so appropriate for tensile loads. According to the fatigue test we did, the elastic part dominates even for low number of cycles. Creep is observed during the test. The epsilon dN is constant for the first 30% of fatigue life and relates with stress according to power law. For the industrial application, we have a requirement to stamp 100 parts and have a thickness reduction less than 0.1 millimeters in 20 millimeters height. It is 0.5%, and we could say that the maximum compressive stress should be less than 55 MPa. And we can also say that 0.1 millimeter thickness increases mechanical properties and also resolution. So we want to acknowledge to IPS for supporting internally this project and for YETA project for supporting some of the workers here in this work. Thank you all for attending this presentation.